Alex Hales struck 100 and Jason Roy hit 5 sixes in a single over as the England Lions opened up their triangular A-team series with a 51-run win over the Sri Lankans in Taunton. James Taylor won the toss and decided to let his batsmen have a go first at a ground where there have been bags of runs of late in one-day cricket, and this day was to be no different, Hales making a promising start, only to lose his opening partner James Vince for 10 in the 7th over, as the Hampshire man pulled a short ball from Lahiro Gamaji to long leg to end an opening partnership of 33. In spite of that loss, the Lions began to dominate once Ravi Bopara joined Hales. 57 runs were taken off the power play, after which there were 11 overs without a boundary. That still didn't stop Hales from getting to a 50 off as many balls. The Nottinghamshire man is having a wonderful season with the bat in all forms of the game and has made no secret of his wish to be playing 50-over cricket for England sooner rather than later. This knot will have done his chances no harm at all. With plenty of ones and twos, the 100 was reached in the 21st over before another half a dozen overs went by without a boundary. Indeed, this was only the second one struck by Bopara, who was at his half century of 74 deliveries. The runs began to flow a little more freely after that as both batsmen picked up the pace. The placement of both was exemplary as they picked their spots to take their side into a strong position of 183 for one with 15 overs of the innings remaining. At the start of over number 37, this four down the ground off Gamaji took Hales to his 100 off 104 balls, that being his 13th four overall. His succession of fist punches shows just what this knock meant to him. He'll have certainly pleased the selectors, who can only have been impressed by the 25-year-old who is really maturing as a batsman. However, he was out next ball, turning a full-length delivery to Danushka Gunatilaka. The batsman was on his way for 101, made out of a score of 198 for 2. Gamaji was the pick of the Sri Lankan bowlers. He also removed Bopara 4 balls later for 74, a typical knock from the excellent Essex batsman. What happened next was, to use a word from Hales later, special. Roy had already taken 15 runs off one over before he launched into Sachith Pathirana. Ball number one of the 41st over was chipped down the ground for a 6. The next delivery saw Roy play a similar shot, sending the ball even further, this time with his very strong wrists. Ball 3 was hit out of the ground, the umpire signalling a 6 before he'd even turned around, such was the flourish from the Surrey man. He has made a name for himself in the T20 format, and he was treating this game as such. The 4th delivery went the same way as the previous 3, and a good gathering at Taunton was starting to slip forward in their seats. Actually, they joyfully booed when Roy played the next ball back to the bowler, only for the last delivery of the over to go travelling again as Roy brought up his 50 off 22 balls. It was simply sensational stuff from a man who knows how to hit a cricket ball. Unsurprisingly, Pathirana was taken off and his replacement, Lahiru Jayaratna, bowled Roy, who was very unlucky to play on after making a memorable 51. But the big hitting didn't end with his dismissal. Two men with test experience in the form of Johnny Bairstow and Taylor simply picked up where Roy had left off. There were some brutal shots, all of these flying over the rope as the Lions made 116 runs off the last 10 overs of their innings, making full use of the work of Hales and Bopara. The domestic game is in an excellent place. Captain Taylor was out, caught off a top-edge sweep for 31, made off 24 balls, after he and Bairstow had added 73 runs in 6 overs. Bairstow ended unbeaten on 50, made from 30 balls, getting to his mark with a single off the penultimate delivery. The Lions ended their 50 overs on 339 for 5, and that was going to prove to be a real test for the Sri Lankans. Harry Gurney started their reply with a wicket in his first over, Mahela Udawata edging to Hales, who eventually held on. The Lions may have thought that the others may roll over just as easily, but Guna Tilaka and Dinesh Chandimal, who has plenty of full international experience and has played in this country a number of times, both produced some excellent shots. 3 summers ago, in fact, Chandimal struck a brilliant 100 against England at Lord's, and he was again in fine fettle here. He drove Tom Smith for a 6, and soon after gave the same treatment to Craig Overton on his home turf, as these two batsmen began to make real progress after nothing more than a steady start. Ravi Patel can only have dreamt of playing in a game like this at the start of this summer, and after a cheap couple of overs, he was also hit over the top by Guna Tilaka. Both batsmen made it to their half centuries. The left-handed opener was there first off 61 balls with this single off Smith. He'd struck 7 fours and that 1 6 off Patel. Next ball, and Chandimal was also raising his bat after hitting his fourth boundary to go with his 2 maximums. He'd used up 56 deliveries for his 50, and these two were giving their side an outside chance of chasing down that mammoth total. The man who was the T20 captain in the Winter's World Cup before dropping himself was by now looking really good, as Smith would testify. This second wicket partnership moved on to 133 in 24 overs. But once Guna Tilaka gave Patel his first wicket by clubbing the spinner to Overton at long on after making 57, the Sri Lankan innings began to subside. Chandimal had made 73 when he was bowled by Bopara, who showed off his all-round skills again. Banuka Rajapaksa gave Patel his second success, the batsman on 33 skewing this shot to Roy. Prasanna then gave the substitute fielder David Willey a catch off Boyd Rankin. It was 205 for 6 in over number 39 when Chatu Ranga da Silva edged a swipe off Gurney to Bairstow. And it was 230 for 7 3 overs later, as Pathirana was totally fooled by Bopara's well-disguised slower ball to lob a simple catch to Hales. The game was just about up for the visitors when their captain, Ashan Priyanjan, was bowled by Overton. A big moment for the Somerset youngster at his home ground. There followed a couple of lusty blows from Ramith Rambut Weller, who hit Patel for successive sixes, before Gamaji mishit a hoik off Rankin to Overton. And the match was finished off by Patel in the penultimate over, as he bowled Rambut Weller for 22, as the Sri Lankans were dismissed for 288. That meant a defeat by 51 runs, with Bopara the pick of the Lions attack, with 2 for 36 from his 10 overs, while Patel claims 3 for 71 from his 10. The Lions take on the New Zealanders next, as they move up the M5 to Bristol on Friday, where the Kiwis also play Sri Lanka on Saturday after their first game was rained off on Tuesday.